الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن سيدنا وإمامنا وقائدنا وحبيبنا رسول الله محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله، اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وأصلي وأسلم على خير البرية محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، أغر عليه للنبوة خاتم من نور يلوح به ويشهده، وضم الإله اسم النبي إلى اسمه إذا قال في الخمس المؤذن أشهد، وشق له من اسمه ليجله، فذو العرش محمود وهذا محمد رسول الله. رسول الله نور لا يضاهى، يفوق الشمس في أجلى ضحاها، فلا يخبو إذا ما الشمس غابت، ولا القمر المنير إذا أضاء، فيا بدر الإله لنا تجلى، ويا نور السعادة في أجلى ضحاها، تعالى الله أهدانا نبيا وأكرمنا بخير الخلق محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليك سيدي يا رسول الله. ثم أما بعد، all praises due to Allah, the creator, the sustainer, the provider, the cherisher, the one who created us to worship him, and he blessed us with lots of blessings and bounties. And he said in the Quran, if you were to count the blessings of Allah, you would never be able to count. And I bear witness openly that there is no God worthy of our worship except him. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. My brothers and sisters in Islam, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring us together in Jannatul Firdaus. Welcome to the masjid, welcome to the house of Allah. Welcome to another Jumu'ah. Of course, we are missing all of you, one by one, individually. We are missing each and every one from one Jumu'ah to another. And we are in love, and we love to see these beautiful faces and radiant ones. May Allah accept from all of us, Allahumma ameen, as we gather together as brothers and sisters in one family, one community. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us steadfast on his deen. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. My brothers and sisters in Islam, in these very little moments or few moments, actually I wanted to highlight a certain point, just one point, about our relationship with Islam and with Allah. How do we look into that relationship? And that will take me actually to the essence, the core message of Islam. And the reason that I'm sharing that topic with all of you, because I felt and I started to observe that lots of people started to be a little bit away from the main and from the essential way of Islam. Islam as a religion, Islam as rules, as halal and haram, Islam as the final message from Allah to the creation is very simple, very easy. The word Islam, it's driven from the word salam. Islam means peace. Islam means mercy. Islam means to be tolerant. Islam means to submit yourself willingly, with no force, no compulsion in religion. You submit yourself with all love, sincerity, and kindness to Allah, the Creator, the Master of all universe. This is the very simple message of Islam. And that's why you can hear from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he said, "Inna ad-deena yusr." Islam, the religion, is so easy. It's so simple. And he said, وَلَنْ يُشَادَّ الدِّينَ أَحَدٌ إِلَّا غَلَبَ. And no one is going to make it hard and difficult to people except Islam itself will defeat him. And not only this, Islam as a religion, it's based on to know Allah, to bear witness that you know who is your creator. Then you start in your journey in Islam. And in the journey itself, people are different based on their capacity, based on their knowledge, based on their ups and downs in Iman. So the Islam as a concept is to know Allah. Allah said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ. Those who said, our master is Allah. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. And they remained steadfast on that way. Then Allah said, the angels will come down to them and give them the glad tidings. Do not be afraid. Do not be in grief. Do not worry. Nothing will happen to you. You will enter Jannah. And all of this, what did they make? They said, رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ. Our master is Allah. And that's why I wanted to share that with all of you. Lots of people nowadays wanted to make Islam to look very complicated, to the point that they pushed away the young generations. Even pushed away some of those who newly reverted to Islam. And they don't feel, they don't understand the real message of Islam. Allah did not make Islam to make our life hard or difficult. And believe me, let me say that very clear and straightforward. If you apply Islam and you feel yourself stressed out, or your life is hard because of Islam, let me tell you today, that is not the Islam of the Prophet Muhammad. Period. And why I'm saying that? Because lots of people did not understand the real message of Islam. Islam makes your life easy, not difficult. Allah said in Surah Al-Baqarah, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. Allah wants your life to be easy. This is a verse in the Quran. Allah said, and He does not want to make it hard on you. Not only this, listen to the message of Rasulullah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day had sent Sayyiduna Mu'adh ibn Jabal, and he sent Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, both of them, to be teachers of Islam, to convey the message. He sent both of them to teach the people of Yemen. And by the way, if you wanted to know the real hospitality, the real generosity, you can visit and see the people of Yemen. And actually, when Rasulullah sent them to Yemen, he gave them one line. He said, يَسِّرُوا وَلَا تُعَسِّرُوا وَبَشِّرُوا وَلَا تُنَفِّرُوا. He said, make it easy, do not make it difficult. Give the good news, the glad tidings. Do not give bad news. This is Islam. This is the message of Rasulullah. So why do we see nowadays that Islam is so complicated? Imam, lots of opinions here and there, halal and haram, and those people are seeing this, and a video on YouTube, and I wanted to understand this. I feel myself lost, confused. You know why? Because simply, you didn't follow the owner of the real message, Rasulullah Muhammad. You started to follow some people who deviated from Islam, who made it hard on people by their fatwas, by their opinions. They made things complicated. And actually, the essence of Islam is so simple. Let me give you an example. Three people, by the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were talking next to his house, and they talked about the worship of Rasulullah. Listen to that astonishing statement. كَأَنَّهُمْ تَقَالُّوهَا. And they talked like as if they said, the worship of the Prophet Muhammad is not enough. Sahaba? Yes. And at the end of the discussion, they said, you know what? One of them said, I will pray, I would never take rest. The second said, I will fast, I would never break my fast. The third one said, I will isolate myself from women, I would never marry. Rasulullah heard them, and he came out, and he said, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, O people, أَمَا إِنِّي لَأَتْقَاكُمْ لِلَّهِ وَأَخْشَاكُمْ لَهُ, أَمَا إِنِّي أَصُومُ وَأُفْتِرُ وَأُصَلِّي وَأَرْقُدُ وَأَتَزَوَّجِ النِّسَاءِ وَهَذِهِ سُنَّتِي فَمَنْ رَغِبَ عَنْ سُنَّتِي فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي. He said, I am the best one of you. I am the most closer to Allah to you. I fear Allah more than of you. And yet, I pray and I take rest. I fast and I break my fast and I marry women. And he said, this is my sunnah. Whoever turned away from my sunnah, he is not one of me. Means on the day of judgment, he is not one of the ummah, the nation of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Islam is very simple. You know, nowadays people became so judging and they became so terrifying actually. Like they are judging people. If they had seen a person praying to Allah, and maybe he's doing a mistake in his salah. Oh, brother, bid'ah. You'll be in the hellfire. Is that Islam? Is that Islam to make people to be frustrated in their relationship with Allah? Instead of helping one another, instead of taking care of one another, and sometimes, you know what? Our Imam, he didn't make Adhan very well because he said, Hayya ala salah, like this. And that means his Adhan is not acceptable, so Salah is not acceptable, so Allah will not accept us. Hold on, who told you this? What kind of knowledge that you might have to judge people? To say somebody will be in Jannah, somebody will be in the hellfire. So who are you to judge over people? Islam is not like this. Islam is the religion for everyone. Islam based on mercy. And let me give you the fatwa. Fatwa. During the time of Rasulullah, one fatwa killed a person. Imam, are you sure? Fatwa? Yes. One day, the Sahaba, where they were in a place in the desert, and one of them, he got a rock in his head, and it made like opened part of his head. He got wound, big wound in his head. So the man put something over the wound and he slept. And subhanAllah, he got a wet dream while he is sleeping. So he needs to have ghusl. He needs to have a shower. When he woke up, he asked Sahaba, he told them, do you think that in my case I can do tayammum just by the dust? Because it's very dangerous to take a shower. They said, no. We don't think that tayammum is applicable to you. And they insisted that you need to have a shower. He took shower. The water went inside his brain. And he died. When the message came to Rasulullah, what did Rasulullah say? He said, قَتَلُوا قَتَلَهُمُ اللَّهُ. Rasulullah made dua against those who made the wrong fatwa. He said, they killed him. May Allah destroy them. He said, it was enough for him to do tayammum. That's all. So why we make people's life difficult? If they are within the frame of Islam, lots of people did not understand. Like somebody prayed the Fard Salah, and for some reason, he is tired, he is busy, he had an appointment, he didn't pray the Sunnah. People look at them, oh, you didn't pray the Sunnah? You do not follow the Sunnah of Rasulullah? You have bid'ah? You don't love the Sunnah of Rasulullah? You are not a good Muslim? And we start judging. judging people. And that's actually a dangerous problem in our societies, in our communities nowadays. Because lots of people didn't understand the ethics, the essential message of Islam. Some masajid are fighting because the Imam said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, silently. And they divide themselves into groups. No, he has to utter it. No, he can't say it silently. And they fight each other in the masjid just because of Bismillah wasn't recited loudly. That's all. That's all. That is Islam. And some people think when they make things difficult, Allah would accept it. The opposite. If you make things easy, Allah would accept it. Let me tell you that narration that maybe it is the first time in your life to hear it. You know who is Mu'adh ibn Jabal? The great Sahabi? Rasulullah gave him the title. He said, أَعْلَمُ أُمَّتِي بِالْحَلَالِ وَالْحَرَامِ. He is the most knowledgeable person in my entire ummah with what is halal and what is haram. This is the person that I'm going to tell you about. He used to pray with Rasulullah. And then, finishing salah, he used to go to lead his community, lead his tribe. And he used to recite in his salah with the entire surah of Al-Baqarah. Al-Baqarah. So one day, a man from his congregation, he left the salah. He intended that I cannot handle it. And he left salah and he left masjid. When Sayyidina Mu'adh knew about that one person had left the masjid, he called him munafiq, a hypocrite. So the man got hurt by that word. And he went to Rasulullah. He explained, he said, Ya Rasulullah, I'm working all the day, standing on my feet. I got tired. I cannot stand behind him the whole time reciting Al-Baqarah. Rasulullah called Mu'adh. He said, is that true? He said, yeah. He said, أفتان أنت يا معاذ? Are you causing fitna in the ummah? From today on, start reciting. I give him examples. He said, recite like Surah Al-Shams, سَبِّحِ اسْمَ رَبِّكَ الْأَعْلَى, and short surahs. Then he addressed the Sahaba, and he said, مَنْ أَمَّ بِالنَّاسِ فَلْيُخَفِّفْ فَإِنَّ فِيهِمُ الضَّعِيفُ وَالْمَرِيضُ وَذَا الْحَاجَةِ الْمَلْهُوفُ. Whoever led the Salah, became an Imam to lead the Salah, let him reduce the time for people because he has those who are sick, those who are weak, somebody who needs to finish something. Do not prolong your salah. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by himself, he said, I might go to lead the salah one day. And in my intention, I wanted to give a little bit of time to enjoy the recitation. Then I hear a child, a baby, crying in the back. Then I decide to shorten the salah because of his mother's feeling. Did you find a religion is so beautiful like this? Taking care of the feelings of the people. So who said that Islam is difficult? You know what made Islam difficult? us. We ourselves, when people mixed the religion with the tradition, they came up with things that does not relate at all to Islam. We made it difficult when we thought that Allah will love us more when we make things more difficult upon us. Islam, and that's my mission, is to give my community the real message of Islam. Do not let people turn away of Islam because of our behavior. Think about the young generations. Think about those who newly came to Islam. When they hear from some of us criticism about their adhan, criticism about their Quran recitation. Oh, Imam, he is reciting, but his tajweed is not good. So why do you want his tajweed to be good? He just reverted to Islam like 2 weeks ago. So what? But Allah will not accept Imam. Did Allah give you a did you sign a contract with Allah to tell you that he would accept or not? And let me be clear today, at that point, you might have a person who barely can recite Surah Al-Fatiha, but his sincerity is better than somebody like me. His sincerity might be better than a qari or reciter for Quran. And I said that golden statement, ليست العبرة بمن سبق إنما العبرة بمن صدق. It's not about who came early to Islam. It's about who has the most sincerity to Allah. Could be a person who just entered Islam, but his heart is so attached to Allah, better than millions of people who born as Muslims. We need to stop judging people. We need to stop looking at Islam out of the context of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And remember this hadith of Rasulullah, that I swear by Allah, most of the ahadith that I have ever memorized in my life, this hadith always in front of my eyes. رب أشعر أغبر ذو طمرين مدفوع بالأبواب لو أقسم على الله لأقرر. You might have a person who is poor, shaggy, disheveled. People are pushing him away from the doors. But if he is to make a dua to Allah, Allah would answer him. So it's not about your degree. It's not about how big is your imama. It's not about your ponytail that you have. It's not about the longest beard. It's not about the shortest garments. It's not about your business account. It's not about your bank account. It's not about your skills. It's not about your model of your car. It's about your heart. Tell people about the real message of Islam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله. الحمد لله الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. My brothers and sisters in Islam, as I had promised to shorten the time of the khutbah, I don't want to make it hard on people so they can pick up their kids from the school, inshallah, رب العالمين. You know, lots of questions come to you as if you are an imam, and lots of emails, imam, what if I have the choice between this and that? And some people think the harder you go, the closer to Allah you will be. And actually, that's not the way of Rasulullah. Listen to the hadith which is in al-Bukhari. And when he said, ما خير رسول الله بين أمرين إلا اختار أيسرهما. Rasulullah would never get the choice to choose between two things except that he will choose the easier. If you are traveling within over the limited miles that Islam had mentioned and you have the permission from Allah to shorten your salah, so why don't you shorten salah? No, Imam, if I prayed for Allah would accept it more. Wrong. That's not Islam. Do you want to tell me that you are closer to Allah than Rasulullah? Rasulullah wasn't given the choice except that he chooses the easier. This is Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So my one message, Islam is the religion of easiness. Islam is very simple. Islam is the religion that actually, if we wanted to be ambassadors of Islam in the United States, and we wanted people to know Islam, they have to see our trust, our truthfulness, our amana. They have to see that we are the people that respect time. It became so custom and normal when you invite Muslims to a certain wedding, you invite them at 7, they come at 10. And they say, you know, Muslims, those are Muslims. No. We are the Ummah of Muhammad. We are the Ummah of discipline. We are the Ummah of Rasulullah. So if you wanted to be an ambassador, I don't know, and I do not need to know how many rak'ahs extra that you had prayed yesterday to Allah. That's between you and Him. But I need, when I deal with you in the halal and the haram, I need to see you upright. I don't need to see you that you are memorizing the entire Quran. What I need to see you applying a verse in the Quran. This is the message. And I hope if you conveyed that message to your family members and your friends, may Allah guide us to the right path. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا اللهم توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين واحشرنا يا ربنا في زمرة خير المرسلين اللهم انصر إخواننا في كل مكان اللهم ثبت أقدامهم اللهم اشف مرضاهم وجرحاهم اللهم تقبل شهداءهم اللهم ثبت الأرض من تحت أقدامهم إنك على كل شيء قدير اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين اشف كل مريض يتألم اللهم اشف كل مريض يتألم إنك على كل شيء قدير وأقم الصلاة قوموا إلى صلاتكم يا حبيبي. Thank you.